Nancy Pelosi defending Dreamers on the House floor for a record 8 hours yesterday. But where was her 8-hour speech defending angel families and the victims of illegal immigrants? Like our next guest, whose 18-year-old son Joshua was killed by an illegal immigrant back in 2010. Joining us now is Laura Wilkerson with her side of the story. Good morning to you, Laura. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. So for folks at home, many of us have heard Josh's story, but for those who haven't, will you tell us what happened?
Sure. Josh was asked to give a kid a ride home from school. He was brought here illegally from Belize by his parents and I think overstayed a 6-month visa. He asked Josh for a ride home. Josh gave it to him, and what he did was beat him to death, torture him, strangle him after death, tied him up like an animal, dropped him in a field, and set him on fire. And he did this so that he could scrap Joshua's truck for some money. He needed some money and didn't know how to make it, so he had to, that's what he resorted to, is
wow.
to do.
That's so sad. Many people are accusing Nancy Pelosi of putting illegal dreamers ahead of American dreamers. Do you agree with that?
I have to laugh at Nancy Pelosi. That story you just said about her, you know, her grandson wanting his skin brown, just it makes me laugh. What a waste of time for Nancy Pelosi and the American public. Does she actually think that we don't know there are hardworking, honest people here that came in the door illegally? I mean, what a waste of time. We understand that. We know that. But what she doesn't understand is that about the law, which is, it's kind of funny that she sits in the position she's in. You know, the law should cover all of that. It makes it non-racist, you know, across the board, not for special interest groups. And that's how we should follow everything that we do so far. I mean, everything that we do. And she just doesn't understand that.
Are you okay with the president's immigration bill? And he's made it crystal clear that he wants to send the criminals home. You know, we just reported a few days ago about that Colts linebacker that was allegedly killed by a guy who was deported 2 times. And the president wants those kinds of people, the criminals, out. He's made it clear that the DACA kids can stay. And in fact, he increased the number to 1.8. Are you okay with that?
Yes, I am okay with that. I think he's doing everything he can to right this country in the way that we need to go moving forward. We have to make some concessions. I know that. We want good people here. I don't think they should have citizenship to be able to vote. But, you know, I am understanding that and compassionate enough to know that some people don't know their home country. I don't think they should be rewarded with anything except maybe being able to live here. I don't want them to be able to vote and to be able to have a say in our political system.
Well, we know that the mayor of New York is very liberal, and we've talked about sanctuary status here in our city. This is an article that was just published. It says NYPD, the New York Police Department, got 1,526 requests to go and detain illegal immigrants under President Trump, but they were all tossed out. They totally ignored those requests. What do you think about that?
I think they need to be let go. I mean, come on, you sort of uphold the Constitution and to uphold law when you took an oath. And you know, that means any kind of law. We can't go back to the system when we don't share information with one source to the other source. I mean, how much would that take us back? It's ridiculous. It's not right.
What's your message to Nancy Pelosi and to these Democrats? Because I remember interviewing Kate Steinle's parents in California, and they said, we didn't even really pay attention to sanctuary city news. It just wasn't something that really affected us until it did, until we lost our daughter.
Right. I think that it is the thing. You know, Nancy Pelosi's talk-a-thon, I think I can speak for all angel parents that would say, you know, we wish she'd do a shut-up-a-thon. And you know, she just wasted her time, everybody's time yesterday. She doesn't seem to get it. And people don't know about sanctuary cities. You know, why do you need to offer people sanctuary from the law? I mean, and you don't know about it till it lands in your lap. So that really is the message to make people understand about sanctuary city and to get on board in their city and make sure that that's not how it goes. Nobody gets sanctuary from the law in this town. I don't care what color you are or where you're from.
I know. Laura, thank you so much for joining us. God bless you.
Thanks.
You're welcome.